All right, good morning. Welcome to Analog Electronic Circuits. This is lecture 17. In the last class, we were looking at the current controlled current source, and we found that when the transistor's got a finite output resistance R naught, the output resistance looking in, what is R out? Very good, it's basically GM times RO times RS plus RO plus RS. Okay. Now, today let's do the following, which is the last thing standing is to figure out what the input impedance is. So, so earlier we have seen what should happen when RL is 0. When RL is 0, what comment can you make about RN? We know this already. Exactly. It's 1 over GM parallel RO, which is basically RO over 1 plus GM times. Okay. All right. Now, the question is what happens when? What is the difference between this result and what we are looking for? Now, we have RN. So, how will we find RN? You can either put a voltage source measure current or current source and measure voltage. What do you think is more appropriate in this case? Current source. Why? Yeah, and the sun rises in the east. You can apply KCL, you can apply KVL, you can apply both, right? All these are correct statements, but you know, why does it make sense to push a, I claim that it's better to push a current and measure the voltage rather than put a voltage and measure the current. In both cases, finally, if you have done the math right, you will get the same answer. What does it make sense to do in this case? When does it make sense to push current and measure the voltage as opposed to apply a voltage and measure the current? When things are in, what is in series here with what? RL is in series with that transistor, right? So it makes more sense to put a current source and measure the voltage, right? And we can do that. But we can also do another thing. Let me, based using our analysis so that we did yesterday. So this is I test. Okay. So what is the, without any doubt, regardless of the value of GM and R naught, what is the voltage at across RL? I test times RL. There's no doubt about this at all. Correct. So basically. This was, so yesterday we did the following. If we put a Vx here and we had left that Rs as a, that resistance in the source was infinite. What was if I call this V test 1, what is V test 1? We saw this yesterday, so please don't annoy me and then, you know, stare at me as if you've never seen this before. It's nothing but, this is nothing but Vx over, Vx over 1 plus GM on. Okay. All right. We've also seen this other situation where What is V test 2? Pardon? It's simply the current they're pushing in multiplied by the looking in impedance. And what is the looking in impedance? That's right, staring at you right in the face, right? It is basically I test times 1 over GM parallel R naught, which is I test times R naught over 1 plus GM R. Given that you know these two results, can we basically say what V test is? RL, very good. So, this basically I test into RL, because this voltage is nothing but I test times RL, right? And remember that you can always remove a component and replace it with a voltage source whose value is exactly the same as the drop across that component. What theorem is that?
Substitution,
right? So, that is basically I test times RL by 1 plus GM R naught plus I test times R O over 1 plus GM R. So, this is nothing but R L plus R O over 1 plus GM R naught. Does that make sense? Sanity check. So, what is the input resistance therefore? What is the input resistance? RL plus R naught over 1 plus GM R naught. Sanity check. RL equals 0, we must get back 1 over GM parallel R naught, which evidently is true. Any other sanity check? If R naught tends to infinity, RN must be equal to 1 over GM. Why does it make sense? If of course comes out of the math, but if R naught tends to infinity, the expression tells us that the input resistance is 1 over GM. Now, question I am asking you is, why does it make intuitive sense? That is, I mean, there is no current in R naught and the answer is 1 over GM is basically saying that this is the equation. I am going to describe the equation to you in words, right? That is not what I am asking for. Why does it, does the result make sense? That is the key point, is that if the output impedance R O is infinite, then whatever happens at the drain has no influence on the drain potential, has no influence on the current in the transistor, period. Correct? So, evidently the voltage at the source cannot be dependent on the whatever you do at the drain, like be it you putting put a voltage source, put a resistor, I do not know, put an elephant, it does not matter. The potential at the source remains unchanged. Right. So, the whatever you put in the drain circuit, if R O is infinite, has absolutely no influence on what happens at the source, which is why it makes sense that whatever the impedance in the drain does not matter as far as R N is concerned, if R naught is infinite. If R naught is not infinite, then what is this formula telling us? It depends on the whatever you do at the drain, right? And I can basically, this is if GM R O is much larger than 1, which is typically true, then what do you expect to see? What does it simplify to if GM R O is much, much larger than 1? R L by GM does not even have the dimensions of resistance. What does this reduce to if GMRO is much, much larger than 1? What can you neglect here? RL plus R naught plus divided by GM R naught, which is nothing but A plus B by C is nothing but A by C plus B by C. Is this so difficult to do? RL over GM R naught plus 1 over. Does it make sense? Right? And so basically we see that if there is a resistance RL in the drain, when looking into the source, it is going to be divided by this factor GM times R naught. Okay, and that is in addition to the 1 over GM that you get. Okay, a common misconception is that the looking in impedance is always equal to 1 over GM. A very easy way of debunking that that myth is basically to see what happens when RL is made infinity. Right, if you open the drain, what is the input impedance? Infinity. Why? Because no current can flow, right? So clearly the looking in impedance must depend on the drain potential. I mean, and must depend on what you do at the drain, okay? And all that the transistor is doing is making sure that the drain potential, the drain impedance when looked at from the source is reduced by this factor GM times R. Is this clear? All right. So, with that, we are done with the four controlled sources.